Good morning. Welcome to the Cathedral of St. Matthew the Apostle, especially to those who are visiting with us for the first time today, and all who are here to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord on this great feast of the church. It's a festive day, and we all look the part. And let's make it a memorable festival of our liturgical celebration by joining in all of the hymns and acclamations. You will have received a program as you entered today, and you'll notice the entrance hymn is a very familiar Easter hymn, which we have a fantastic accompaniment with the brass and the organ and the choir. So we hope you'll join in and not just enjoy what you hear by listening, but actually become one of the music ministers today by participating fully. There's a thrilling experience in a space like this when everyone sings along with something. So give yourself and your neighbors that experience by joining in and being a part of this festivity. You'll notice the Gloria and many other responses are also there, and they're quite easy to follow. So please, you're encouraged and welcome to join along. Leading us in our celebration today is the Archbishop of Washington, Cardinal Wilton Gregory. And we are just delighted that you're here also to celebrate with us on this feast day. Let's join now in singing our opening hymn, Jesus Christ is Risen Today.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dearest brothers and sisters in the Lord, from the heart, happy Easter. We gather with great joy on this Easter Sunday, knowing that the Father's love is perfect. He's willing to raise us with his Son to newness of life and to forgive all our sins.
You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
You came to call sinners. Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
You are seated at the hand of the Father to intercede for us. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice, let us rejoice, let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the
which the builders rejected.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we do not know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Beloved friends in Christ Jesus, keeping track of time is an essential concern for all of us. Each one of us at one time or another must have felt like we were a mere prisoner of time. Most of us learn to wear and to take advantage of the convenience of watches as relatively young children. One of the early lessons in school that we all learned is how to tell time. We have countless clocks, calendars, and now smartphones in all of our lives, in our homes, cars, schools, and offices. We are very much aware of the value of time in allotting the moments of our lives. We can now use atomic clocks to calculate an even more precise time of day. Twice each year, we change our clocks to take the greatest advantage of the presence of the sun. Every 4 years, we adjust the calendar by one day to keep our days aligned with the exact movement of the earth around the sun. And occasionally, we even add a leap second or two for greater precision. Whether we use the Julian or the Gregorian calendar, we depend upon those charts to help us calculate the secular and the religious moments of our lives. Most of us would feel lost without the mechanisms and the charts that keep us aware of the days, the hours, and the minutes of life. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. It was very important for John, the gospel writer, to take note that these events happened on the first day of the week, Sunday, and that they took place very early in the morning. Something about time intrudes into the very telling of this most important story of faith. The first day of the week, the very day on which God started his creation in the first place. In darkness, before the sun rose, the true sun rose. John's story is all about the recreation of time and all those elements that God had first fashioned at the beginning of time. Easter resets all the clocks and calendars in our lives and in our futures. Easter is the first day of the new creation. Everything that God had initially created and the time had been judged to have been very good has now been made perfect on Easter. God's most amazing creature, man, was made new and even more godlike on Easter. That creature that God had first fashioned in his image has become even more a true reflection of God. All the flaws and all the imperfections that had found their way into creation were set right on Easter Sunday, the new first day of the week. And the sun that rose that day will never set. Darkness is forever banished because of this new day of creation. Jesus is the new Adam, perfect in every fashion, and his resurrection is the commencement of a new era that eventually, in God's time, will bring all of us into that new creation. Our Christian faith tells us that the resurrection is the correction and the transformation of all that was flawed in the first universe. Jesus himself is the perfect new man and the prototype of what we shall all become, you and me, in God's new creation. As we celebrate once again this primary feast of the Christian calendar, we are reminded to change our clocks, not just to advance them 1 hour forward or backward, not merely to add another leap day to the calendar so that we are in sync with the sun, not even to add a leap second or two so that our time devices are more accurate, but to anticipate living in a new moment of perfection because of Christ's resurrection from the dead. Easter is the dawn of a new world and the beginning of a new era that transforms all of creation and extends the invitation to all of us to begin living in a new way within this perfect creation. We are all born again through water and the Holy Spirit. Just as that first birth that we experienced was accomplished by passing through the amniotic waters of life, so too is our new birth accomplished through the waters of the baptismal font. The womb of the church has brought forth new children once again, as our newly baptized glistening with the chrism of salvation, remind us everything is made new in the light of Christ's resurrection. So reset your watches, your clocks, and your calendars, not simply to have them be more precise, but to have them remind us all that a new day has dawned and we are destined to live forever in God's time. Amen. Now set those watches so that they are correct. Alleluia. My dearest sisters and brothers in the Lord, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I now ask all of you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us the forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life.
Amen.
Springs of water, bless the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love endures.
In the Easter mystery, the Father has recreated our world in joy, peace, hope, and light. Let us now offer our prayers to the Father of us all.
That the splendor of the risen Christ may draw many to surrender their lives in service to God's people as ordained, consecrated, and lay ministers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That peace may prevail throughout the world, and that the Holy Spirit inspire government leaders to work for justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the hope of Christ, the firstborn from the dead, may console those who mourn, comfort those deprived of shelter and homeland, and heal the wounded, the sick, and the suffering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish community may proclaim in our work and worship the good news of the resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of life, author of love, in raising your Son from the grave, all of creation has been reborn. May the life and love of the Paschal mystery, which we celebrate today, be a constant and lasting reality in our lives. Through Christ our Lord.
Alleluia, Deo dicamus gratias.
pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise of the Lord his name,
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, with Roy and Juan and Avilio, our auxiliary bishops, with Donald William, our retired archbishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus, Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Chrysogonus, Lawrence, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously, accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you, also for those to whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant us some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs. With John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory, the
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord.
Señor.
Esto es la puerta que Dios nos ha dado, todos los justos por ella entrarán.
Oh,
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only Son, begotten, endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.